The gentle lady from Iloilo.
Thank you. We're in the process of explaining our individual votes. I've already announced to the media priorly that I was going to vote in favor of obedience to the TRO for the following grounds. Now I will try to summarize them very quickly. Under law, there is such a thing as a last clear chance doctrine. If both parties are at fault, perhaps in an automobile collision, but one party had the last clear chance to avoid the collision but did not take that chance, then he is the one who is at fault. Today, we have a TRO issued by the Supreme Court against the impeachment court. The Supreme Court is what its name implies, the Supreme Court. This, by contrast, is just the High Court of Impeachment. If we do not obey the TRO, then we are engaged in a collision course. And it is now for the Senate to avail of the last clear chance to avoid a collision, which will naturally result in a constitutional collision. That is the first argument. The second argument is this. Under the 1987 Constitution, the Supreme Court is vested with judicial power. There are two components of judicial power. One is the power to decide justiciable issues. Two, another component peculiar only to the Philippine Constitution is that the Supreme Court has power over political questions. In that manner, therefore, the 1987 Constitution has already abolished the political question doctrine, which is still observed in other democracies like ours, particularly in the United States. So, if that is the case, then the Supreme Court has a more comprehensive extent of judicial power than that possessed by the United States Supreme Court because of this constitutional provision. The case of Nixon versus United States involved a federal judge who, under American law, is authorized to be impeached by the Senate. Here we don't have that system. Therefore, the ruling in U.S. versus Nixon does not apply to the Philippine jurisdiction. It is, of course, a valid decision to be cited in American law, but not in Philippine law because of our constitutional provision is markedly different. Third ground, the secrecy of bank of foreign currency deposits law is a child of this Congress. We passed that law and said the secrecy of foreign currency deposits is absolute except and only except when the depositor himself gives his consent. We made that condition sole, alone, and by itself. We made that law. Now are we going to break that law? Lawmakers cannot be lawbreakers. Fourth ground, the theory of checks and balances prohibits this impeachment court from claiming an exception unto itself. Under the theory of separation of powers, there are three branches of our government, as enumerated in our Constitution. There is no specific provision in the Constitution that our governmental system is divided into three branches, but you can imply it from the fact that there are three separate and successive articles in our Constitution headed with the titles, the legislative branch, the executive branch, and then the judicial branch. So by implication, we imply that our government has three branches. Now, under the system of checks and balances of a tripartite system of government, each branch has power to check or to modify the actions of other branches. That is the system of checks and balances. Even the Supreme Court is not final in its decisions. This Congress, for example, can go against the grain of a Supreme Court decision and in that way overrule or overturn the decision of the Supreme Court. Who are we that we should claim an exemption from the principle of checks and balances which underlies the very system of government under which we operate? Who are we? Is the impeachment court illimitable? Are the powers of the impeachment court infinite? Are we almighty above all the three other branches of government? We are not even mentioned in a separate article. We are the impeachment court mentioned only under the article concerning accountability of public officers. So if we do not recognize Supreme Court, who therefore do we recognize? Nobody? Nobody's checking the impeachment court? Is that your theory? Fifth ground, disobedience to the TRO violates the defendant's human rights. The separation of powers doctrine was invented to protect the individual rights, the individual and his rights, or in other words, his human rights. So it becomes a question of how much judicial review should the Supreme Court exercise over the impeachment court. I humbly submit that it should not be full judicial review, that it can check us at any point. Those are the nightmares of someone who is not educated in the democratic process. I humbly submit that the Supreme Court has the power to exercise the most minimum judicial review. Who decides what is the most minimum judicial review? The impeachment court. Finally, sixth ground. In at least two previous cases, the Supreme Court has already ruled that it has power of judicial review over impeachment cases. These are the two cases of Francisco V. Nagmamalasakit, decided in 2003, and this very new case of Gutierrez versus House of Representatives. If that is the case, then we follow judicial precedent. It is already a standing rule in law. Thank you.
Majority Floor Leader.
Thank you, Mr. President. Senator Jing.